Imagine a pendulum where the ball traces out a horizontal circle as it swings. So this is not the usual back and forth motion you'd expect. It swings in a circle, drawing a perfect cone as it swings. And this is what we call a conical pendulum. And you can see that unlike the regular pendulum, where the ball moves only in a vertical plane, the conical pendulum moves in a three-dimensional plane. So let's understand in five steps how the forces interact here. In step one, we will identify all the forces. We can see the ball is attached to a string of length L and swings, making an angle beta with the vertical axis. So what this means is, if you freeze the motion of the pendulum at any time, you will find that the angle with the vertical is beta. Now, two main forces act on the ball. Weight W is equal to mg, acting vertically downwards, and tension in the string that has two components. And we will label tension in the string as F instead of the usual T, because later on we will derive the time period T, and I therefore want to avoid any confusion. Okay, step two is decomposing the tension into its respective components. So F can be broken down into a vertical component, F cos beta, and a horizontal component, F sine beta. Then with the ball in circular motion, it's a horizontal component that provides the necessary centripetal force for this unique movement. In step three, we will write the F is equal to ma equation for xx and yy directions. So we will first write the equation for yy axis, where F cos beta minus mg equals zero. And it is zero on the right hand side because the ball is not moving vertically, and therefore acceleration A is zero. So F cos beta is equal to mg. Then we can see that the horizontal component gives us a centripetal force needed for circular motion, or we can write F sine beta is equal to ma radial, which equals mv square upon r. And a radial is nothing but the centripetal acceleration. And v is the speed of the ball, and r is the horizontal distance from the ball to the vertical axis. Also, we can see that r is equal to l sine beta. Now, step four is expressing the centripetal acceleration in terms of angle beta. So from this equation, A radial relates to beta as A radial is equal to F sine beta upon M. Then using this equation, we can say F is equal to mg upon cos beta. And if we substitute this expression for F here, what we get is A radial is equal to g tan beta. And in final step five, we will find the time period T of oscillation. Now, we know that the period T is the time taken for one complete revolution of the ball. That would be a distance of 2 pi r, and can be expressed as T is equal to 2 pi r upon v. That is simply the formula time is equal to distance upon velocity, where distance here is the circumference and v is the velocity. But from this equation, we get v is equal to root of rf sine beta upon m. And if we substitute the value of f as mg upon cos beta from this equation, what we get is v is equal to under root gr tan beta. Now we can use this value of v here to find the time period t as t is equal to 2 pi root of L cos beta upon g. And this formula tells us a lot. So for a given length L, that is if we keep it fixed, as the angle beta increases, cos beta decreases, and the time becomes smaller, and the tension F is equal to mg upon cos beta goes up. However, the angle can never be 90 degrees, because then T would become zero and f would become infinity, and v would also become infinity. So you could say that a conical pendulum could never make a very good clock because the period depends on the angle beta in a very direct way. So if you like this lesson, I would say that this playlist on friction, circular motion and drag force would be particularly useful for you. And if you liked the lesson, do give a thumbs up, which will be very helpful, and see you in the next video.